guys, welcome back to my channel. So in my previous video, I had shown a few gifting ideas using mason jars. If you haven't already watched that, I'll leave a link somewhere here and as well in the description box below so you can check it out. And in this video, I'll be showing you different kinds of photo frames that you can make, which do not have to be particularly for your loved ones, but you can also make it for yourself to decorate your room with it. So before further ado, let's get straight into the video. So this frame is like the perfect lovey-dovey type, which is full of hearts, which I'll be showing you how to make. For this, you'll be needing some colorful hearts. You can stick to a theme for it and a good quality photo. You'll also be needing some scissors, some glue and a ribbon. So to be on the safer side, I'll only place the hearts in the picture in the desired shape and not stick it. Once I'm happy with the shape, I'll proceed with the sticking. As you can see, I've used two sizes of hearts. One is the bigger one and the smaller one will help us to stick two bigger ones together. Once done sticking, we have a frame ready. Now coming to the photo, I'll just make a rough outline on the picture according to the frame and then cut the photo and stick it with the frame. Before sticking the photo with the frame, don't forget to stick a ribbon on the frame so that you can hang the picture. Once you're done, this is how it'll look. Next, we have the simple cute frame with just some extra elements added to it. For this, you'll be needing a good quality photo, scissors, glue, some decorative things if you need, a cardboard to stick them on, and I've written the names of the couple in the format of a crossword puzzle. First, we'll start with cutting the photo, the crossword puzzle, and the hearts if you're using any. You do not have to only write the names of the couple, but you can also replace it with writing I love you or any other thing. Once done cutting, you can just place it on the cardboard and stick it if you're satisfied with it. I wasn't satisfied with the white one, that's why I replaced it with the black one. Once you're done sticking, you can either get it framed or you can leave it like this. I prefer getting it framed. Next, we have this simple yet cute alphabet frame. For this, you'll be needing the cardboard and the prints. The pictures and the alphabets have been edited by myself. You can also go to any print shop and ask them to do so. Once you're done cutting, you can stick it on the cardboard and get it framed or leave it as it is. And this is how it'll look once it's done. Now coming to my favorite of all these. For this, you'll be needing a cardboard, a scissors,
a glue if you're not using sticker sheets, and the photo. As you can see, I've posed for the word love with each picture having a single letter. Then once you've got the pictures, you need to just cut them and stick them in the desired manner. If you want, you can add some stickers or anything as well, or you can just leave it plain just like I did. Once you're happy with the way it is, you can get it framed or you can just leave it as it is.
So these were all the ideas for photo frames that I had in my mind. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. And again, if at all you're using any of these ideas, don't forget to post a picture on Twitter, Instagram or Facebook and tag me in it, because I'll be very happy to see them. So that's it for today, guys. Bye. Take care. Love you.